أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم ألا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا ولا نحن نرزقكم وإياهم ولا تقربوا الفواحش ما ظهر منها وما بطن ولا تقتلوا النفس التي حرم الله إلا بالحق ذلكم وصاكم لعلكم تعقلون ولا تقربوا مال اليتيم إلا بالتي هي أحسن حتى يبلغ أشده وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط لا نكلف نفسا إلا وسعها وإذا قلتم فاعدلوا ولو كان ذا قربى وبعهد الله أوفوا ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تذكرون ولا تتبعوا السبل فتفرق بكم عن سبيله ذلكم وصاكم به لعلكم تتقون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. First and foremost, I would like to welcome all of you and thank you very much for coming here. The blessing of having a secure environment is from the most magnificent of blessings that God has bestowed upon us. Because security is what allows civilizations to thrive. And therefore you will find tens of verses and ahadith, teachings of Prophet Muhammad, emphasizing the importance of safety and security for people to be able to practice their religion. Safety for individuals' right to practice their faith, lives, family, honor, and wealth. These are the five objectives of Islam and whatever scripture or book of God throughout history has always been revealed to protect. It is well known that a man cannot live a fulfilling and comfortable life without peace and security for them and their families. Likewise, nations and civilizations do not develop without the stability of various types, political stability, economic stability, and none of this happens unless there is a common identity among the masses, so that they have a common objective and vision for their future. Without such a unity, the society has no basis to cooperate. There is a verse in the Quran that says, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Cooperate and work together on piety, on righteousness, not on transgression and disobedience. Islam took a firm stance against corruption. And if we just to bring this to your information, that in the last speech of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, which is the sermon that he felt was his last, and he wanted to summarize the major points of this divinely ordained way of life which he brought to establish a unique, refined, and humane society. He started it with this, and he passed like 3-4 months after this farewell speech in his farewell pilgrimage. He started it with, "Oh people." It is very important. He did not say, "Oh Muslims," or Arabs. He said, "Oh people, listen to me, for I do not know if I will meet you again or not." And he said, "Your wealth, honor, blood are sacred to you until the day you meet your Lord. Your blood, your honor, your wealth are sacred to you, lying until the day you meet your Lord, like the sanctity of this day of yours, in this month of yours, in this city of yours." And he also, peace be upon him, said, "Your Lord is one, your Father is one. You come from Adam, and Adam came from dust." So he confirmed the oneness of the Creator, the oneness of mankind's origin from a single Father, and also the oneness of the source, namely dust. Wealth and blood are sacred for all times. And the Prophet made it clear, he said, "Oh people," so this message would remain addressed to all of mankind until Judgment Day. "Oh people, Ya Ayyuhan Nas." And when he says Ya Ayyuhan Nas in Arabic, it includes Muslims and non-Muslims. All walks of life, people from all walks of life are included in the speech of the Prophet, peace be upon him. And in Islam, killing the soul is a serious crime. In Islam, killing the soul is a serious crime. Killing the soul unjustly is like killing all of mankind. This is what Quran says. And saving it is like saving all of mankind. Killing the soul unjustly is like killing all of mankind. And saving it is like saving all of mankind, regardless. Regardless of the differences that we have in our races, in our colors, in our languages, in our homelands, regardless of all of this. So we are here, all of us today, to stand against violence toward anyone, anyone from any religion, regardless of his color, his race, his language, his homeland. Because we reject violence. And violence, what we know, that has no room in any religion, not only in Islam, but it has no room in any other religion whatsoever. So we, just to let you know that we reject this toward anyone, this is what the Quran teaches us, and this is what the teachings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, teach us. Our doors are open 24/7 to all of you. Feel free to come, ask questions, so we can break the barrier between us and you. And we need to break it. We need to break it. There are some non-Muslims almost come every single Friday to listen to my speech. Within the past 3 years, coming every single Friday. They don't miss even one single Friday. They come, sit in the back, and watch us, what we are saying, what message are we giving to people. And our message is very clear. Very clear. So, once again, thank you very much. And Jazakum, may Allah bless you all for coming here and taking time to come and participate in this great event. So, in this we, in this day and in this blessed hour, we offer our condolences to the victims of UNC, to Kayla, to the American journalist, to the Jordanian pilot, to all victims who were killed unjustly, to all the innocent people who got killed for no reason. We offer our condolences to their families, and we ask God to grant them patience. Allahumma ameen. Thank you very much.